All right, even with an inexpensive scanner here, this is just an AutoFix OM129 Pro. And if you want to have one that also does battery testing, make sure you get the Pro. I'll put a link to this scanner down below the video, but the code that comes up is U1510. That is a code that can also relate to your HVAC or heating, air conditioning controls. So if you see that code and your heating and air conditioning is working okay, you're basically, your only other option is the louvers out on the front of the truck. I also borrowed a better scanner here that gives me more information on what this thing has to say about the codes, and this one does pick up an ambient air temperature sensor too, which I believe is related to the same component out front. And I printed out the service manual. I'll put this up on the screen so you can read it better and follow along with me here, but what this says is the active grille air shutter actuator closes louvers at the front of the bumper to enhance vehicle aerodynamics in driving situations. If high airflow levels are required, the active grille air shutter actuator opens the louvers. Long story short, this will set the U510 code, which is what I have. So we're gonna go ahead and swap this thing out. I'll show you how to do this. It's behind the grill.
And there is a huge mouse nest or a bird's nest or some kind of crap
built in there that's keeping those louvers from closing. First thing you'll want to do is go ahead and pull all these pins out of this plastic cover on the top here. There's probably 9 or 10 of them. They make a special tool for this, but just a flat screwdriver works perfectly fine. Once you get all those out, just work it around your little hood stops there. Pull it up in the back and then slide it back out from under the grill. And then that comes right off of there. Now, to get the grill off of these trucks, you've got 4 bolts across the top here, and you've got 2 bolts down here. You need an extension for that, but there's one back there, and there's one back there. You got a total of 6 bolts, and then the rest of it is just held on by clips that you just have to pull out. These bolts are 10 millimeters. I like to just go ahead and take the ones out down here on the front first. If you're really lucky, you can get it out of there without dropping it. Do the same thing on this side. Then the 4 bolts across the top here. So you got a total of 6 bolts. Once you get those out, it helps take a couple flat screwdrivers and just slide that back under here. You've got to get this clip right here out from underneath that metal piece. So just pull that up like that. Leave your screwdriver in there. Take another one on the other side. Do the same thing over here. And just get that up so that grill is loose. There's also a pin right here. This is in the center. You got to make sure you pull that straight forward. Once you get those out, you should just be able to pull the grill forward. Once you get all that out, just pull it out and get it out of your way. All right, now that I got that grill off here, I'll show you what I've got. I've already cleaned this out, but I'll put some pictures up here to show you what I found when I took this off. I'm pretty sure having all this nest and stuff built up in this grill is what caused it to burn itself up, because I did clean this out and try to get it working. Also checked the fuse. If you look underneath your fuse panel, it's fuse 47, which is that one right there. If you're having this issue, before you go trying to replace anything, check your fuses first. It may be something to do with a burned up fuse. Something else I'll show you here. Some of these bolts you can actually see through the main grill. That's why it was very clear. There's only 4 bolts across the top, and then there's 1 bolt right here and 1 bolt right here. You'll notice this is broke. This truck's hit a deer before. So I'd say this has been replaced once before. I bought this truck with 105,000 miles on it. It's got 106,000 on it right now. Even though you can see some of these other bolts through the grill, they don't have to come out until you get the grill completely off. So that should help you get this off. This is where your clips mount. So this is what you're fighting. Got a clip here. Each one of these brackets where these bolts are at, there's a clip in each one of them. There's 2 clips right here. Obviously one of mine's broken, but there should be 2 there. And then you've got clips here in the side. I've got another broken clip right here. So you'll have one here that makes it a little hard to get yours off. So you can see here on this side, but that'll give you an idea of what you're fighting here. Now, I've also seen where people go in through here, take like a tire tool, go down through here and you can push that out from behind. Just try to help you out there. As I know, getting that grill off the first time I did it was kind of a challenge. This is your plug right here above the passenger side headlight. This usually clips back in there. I've already pulled it out. Generally, there's a little red tab here you can pull. This broke off when I tried to pull this out the last time, so I just stuck the little piece of it down in there. Pull that tab out. Yours will have a little lever on the top of it. And then this right here pushes down, and then this will just pull apart. So that's the only connection straight to the truck, and that's what it looks like when you're looking to buy this. Plugs right into that. Make sure that connection is good too when you put this back on. When you go to take the louvers themselves out, I think you got 12, 13 bolts around here, I believe. Go ahead and pull them out, and then this will pull right out the front. This does have a couple clips that kind of hold it in place too. Just kind of pull that loose. There's a clip like right in here somewhere. Just pull that out, and then this will come right out. All right, something else you got to do here. I got this flipped around backwards now. You got to take this little temperature. This is your ambient air temperature sensor. This has to go into the new louvers. So just go ahead and pull this out, and that just pulls out there. So we need this piece to go back into the new one, and then this piece is garbage. I hope this isn't an issue, but the new one does say that PCM reflash with scan tool may be required. I haven't seen that anywhere else in anybody else's video, but I think the scan tool I've borrowed from a friend has that option, but this one is closed, so hopefully it'll open up. We'll try it out here before I put the main grill back on, make sure everything opens up the way it's supposed to. As of December 2023, this was $220 off of Amazon. I'll put a link down below for you. It was the least expensive place I could find it. At some of the auto parts stores around here, this thing was actually over $300. Go ahead and plug our sensor back in here. Make sure that seats down in there real well and clicks. And then we'll slide this right back in this hole. Just get these little push clips lined up here, and then your bolt holes should line up. Just kind of a snug fit. Make sure our temperature sensor is still showing through there the way it's supposed to. We'll go ahead and plug this thing back in even before I bolt it up and try it out here. All right, and I see this one does have the new lock on it. When you put it back on, just push that down, and that ensures that locks this plug together. And then this just goes back into this little hole right here. All right, now before I even put the bolts back in this thing, I got the plug hooked up and everything turned on. I'm gonna go activate the key and just see if I can get these louvers to open up here. All right, on the snap-on scan tool I've got borrowed here, this was borrowed from Kiss Auto Glass. Guys, if you're in the Cincinnati area, check out Kiss Auto Glass for any of your automotive glass needs. He let me borrow this, and I am really appreciative of that. It's a 2018. This scanner only goes up to 2017, but it does seem to work fine. This is a 4.3 V6. Which one it was. I was in here and there's a place to turn the fans on and off. All right, it took me a minute to find this, but under the main engine menu, under the code scan, there is a function test. We'll go ahead and do function test. Was it output controls? Yeah, there we go, cooling fan. So I can turn the cooling fan on, and my assumption is if the cooling fans are on, we can see down here, it should open up the active grill. So let's turn the fans on. Let's set them at 90% and see what happens here with our active grill shutter. Still got the GoPro set up out front there, so hopefully it'll catch this open. Check engine light is still on. Turn the fan on to 90%. You can hear the fans kicking on. And there goes our active grill shutter. Yeah, let's go out and look at it and see if it opens up. So the shutters did open, and I'm able to see on here active grill shutter movement. It's a nice thing about having a good scanner. You can see a lot more than what you can actually see with one of the less expensive ones. Check engine light is still on. I'm not going to reset it, but I think you have to cycle the key a few times. I think it has to see communication a couple times before it'll turn that light back out. All right, so let's turn it back on here. And I don't know, the tire, I don't have tire sensors in my tires. That's causing an issue with my anti-lock brakes being signaled that the tires are low. So I'm not sure if that'll turn the check engine light on or not. Active grill shutter is definitely working though. Let's do a code scan on it again.
Go ahead and shut the key off here. Turn it back on, but I won't start it. Just do a basic code scan on it. All right, that code is still coming up there. Might have to clear the codes out. I don't know if it'll reset on its own or not. I think the anti-lock brake code's there because if I reset my tire pressure sensors, those codes go away for the anti-lock brakes. I don't know. Let's go ahead and get this thing bolted back in, get the grill back together because I know it's working now. I'll leave that check engine light on. I'm not going to reset that, and I'll take it for a drive and see if it goes out on its own. If not, I'll reset it and see if it stays out.
All right, I'll just go ahead and get these bolts back in here and get them all tightened down.
All right, you might laugh at me on this one, but I wanted to make sure I eliminated my tire pressure sensors as being an issue. So what I did, we're gonna take this and hold this for 5 seconds to enable the tire pressure relearn. Yes, the horn should beep twice. That tells us we're in active learn mode. And then what I did was took 4 tire pressure sensors, mounted them in a piece of PVC pipe, and then blew it up to 35 PSI. So we're gonna go ahead and take our tire tool. All right, got one sensor active, 2 active, 3 active. Oh, come on, I know it's in there. All right, tire learn, done. So we got 41 PSI. There's our tire pressure sensor fooler. So that turned off our tire light. So now we can definitely know for sure that if that light stays on, it's because of something else. Okay, again, not gonna reset it. Tire light should be out now though. Let's see if that worked. All right, tire light's out. First time since I've owned this truck. That is still on. I'm gonna go out and shut the hood. We're gonna see if we can't get this thing working. I like that. All right, I flipped this back over to this screen here. So we got 106,005 miles. Check engine light's still on. I'm just now starting to drive. Engine's just now getting up to temperature. I like that tire light being out though, isn't that cool? It's literally been... All right, I am gonna go ahead and pull over here and shut this thing off. Turn the key on, ignition not running, and go ahead and reset this check engine light and see if it stays out. Now, up to this point, I have not had to do any kind of relearn or anything for this shutter, so hopefully I don't have to. But I'll just go in here, go home, scanner, Chevrolet. All right, we're just gonna clear all codes, read by scan tool. Cleared the anti-lock brake codes. Hopefully that was because of the tire sensors. Check engine light is currently still on. Should go off here in just a minute. Okay, we'll cycle the key off. Turn the key back on. Check engine light is out. Hopefully it still remembers my tire pressure sensor fooler too. So I think we drove about 10 miles. So we'll drive back home and see if that light stays out. How cool is that? That tire pressure light is out though. It's now the next day and I've restarted this truck a few times since I reset that check engine light, and I've driven a little over 110 miles. Current mileage on the truck is 106,129, and the check engine light is still out. Everything appears to be working the way it's supposed to. And guys, if you found any value in this video, consider checking out this video right here. I'll post more videos on this truck and I'll keep you updated if that check engine light comes back on. Until next time, drive safe and we'll see you on the flip side.